the grace and peace of God our Father, the Lord Christ, hear you, in the waters of baptism, and he died with Christ, and rose with him in new life. We should now share with him eternal glory.
Jesus went to a town called Egan, accompanied by his disciples and a great number of people. When he was near the gate of Catawba does a dead man and speed carry us for burial. The only son was one, and she was a widow. And a considerable number of adult people were with her. When the Lord saw her, he felt sorry for her. He loves crying, and said, then went on and put his hand in the ear, and the bear stood still. And he said, young man, I tell you, get up. And the dead man sat up and began to talk. And Jesus gave him to his mother. Everyone was filled with awe and praised God, saying, a great struggle has appeared among us. God has visited his people. And this Arabian news spread throughout today and all over the country. This is the time of the year when we are supposed to be in joyful expectation of the Christmas season. And death would certainly be done by the Spirit for those who long for heaven. And it would certainly be released by your daughters and nephews, daughters and sons, and she, Margaret, Katrina, and Peter. Also, by every other grandchildren. Grandchildren, nieces, nephews, sons, daughters, and girls, extended family, neighbors, and high school friends. I have come to know many in the course of my first 20 calls. We did not talk about because of the COVID mandates to limit time. Pastoral business. But we have developed our first rally called Ritual, which begins with my greeting of good morning and her smiling was unable to respond to my greeting. I would ask, would you like to receive sacrament today? I would ask that she would make the sacrament across, and after a moment of silence, she would indicate she is not ready to receive this. The sacraments. It would end with a smile again and a soft, thank you, Father, as I prepared to leave the room. And it was born on the 1st of July 1924 in Rapportura, overlooking Lucky. She had two brothers and a sister. At 7 days, she brought her sister to England. As a nurse, leaving behind a child of a sweeter Jew who only lived half a mile from her home. He married here in the Parish in 1951 and returned to England for several years. He had two sons and three daughters. He doubled traveling to the US to visit their two sons and daughter, immigrating to New Jersey. When she passed away in 1987, she traveled as much as she could to see her family without him. She learned to visit from her grandchildren and they received the great grandchildren. And indeed, all the rest of her long life was in their work. I asked Father Dito, a Buddha who for almost 2 years would call the man in the first prayer called the first prayer. to the next. Always true to her thoughts, she anticipated that she was in her mind. One time, she asked Father Tito, "Father, do you think I will go to heaven when I die?" And Father Tito replied, jokingly, "Well, we might have a problem with that, because as I know, heaven is a smoking area." And the whole room burst in laughter. She was a very devout Catholic, and the family was very important to her. She is remembered as a woman with a gentle soul. She finds peace in the moments. She was proud of her children. And she reminded us, Father Peter, we played the song Amazing Grace on the day of her funeral. And also Father Peter offers his condolences to the family and offered us for Henry in his parish in the Philippines. It is with such a heavy heart today we all meet Annie and I. Yet the gospel we have listened to comforts and assures us that the compassion which can invade our hearts at the time of the death when the behavior of the gospel was also in Jesus' heart for us. The raising up of the young man in our gospel is a symbol of how Jesus praises us when we are done. The sorrow and the pain of his heart lets us know that we are understood, we are accepted, we are welcomed to the loving heart of God. In times of darkness, let us remember that Jesus, the great prophet, hailed us by the mourners, is with us yesterday, today, and forever. Death is that moment in which total defeat is transformed by total victory. We beat Annie and I, as God welcomes her home, as she is the child of the Father, whose love is stronger than death. Life is eternal because his love is everlasting. She now makes her last stretch of her journey to the Father's house to be reunited once again with Jimmy, her brothers and sisters, family, Mary and Jimmy, daughter of the blindness, like a bulbous plant on our earth, waiting to give her a warm welcome. Eternal rest of her to her, who was connected her rich life.
We thank God for giving the privilege of going by and thank her for trying to do so much in her eyes. God hears. For all who is ready, that the Lord will give them whom her comfort and be their compassion during this time of sorrow. Lord, hear us. For all our deceased relatives and friends, that they may enjoy the right to heaven and the cooking of the saints. Lord, hear us.
Thank you.
which will be given for you. In a certain arrangement, examples that he took each other as a mouse for giving thanks, he gave it these disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from this. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we meet this friend,
I'd like to take this opportunity to thank a few people. All mom's carers and their late friends in the area. I also want to thank Marty and Mary Nixon for calling to see mom on a regular basis and always being there for my sister. To Fiona, I say thank you. Mom was very fond of you and loved having a smile every day. And last but not least, I want to thank Francis and Anne. On behalf of Jim, Katrina, Pio, and myself, we especially want to thank you, Anne, for taking care of Mom all these years. We appreciate it more than we could ever say. And to Mom, I want to say that Anne, Francis, Jonathan, and Clemmie are so sorry that they can't be here today.
Saints of God, God the Lord, is at the to be your angels of the Lord. Receive your soul and present her to God on most high. May Christ the Lord take it in his son. May angels lead it to the bosom of ever comes. Receive your soul and present her to God on most high. Eternal blessed grant to your Lord and the perpetual and shining honor. Receive your soul and present her to God on most high. To you, Lord, we commend our business, all of our business in heaven, your servants, and the sight of his word. She is now dead. In your sight, we should be forever. Forgive all of our sins which committed to you, my goodness, and in your goodness, grant our everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sins for our place of Christ.
Power on. Power off.
By the way, Sister Annie has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ, in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our sister. Together we meet Christ Jesus, when he who is our life appears in glory. And we read from the sacred scriptures, from the letter of, from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, verse 39. This is the will of my Father, says the Lord, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day. O God, by whose mercy and faithful, by whose mercy the faithful departed find rest, bless this grave, and send your holy angel to watch over it as we bury here today the body of our sister. Deliver her soul from every bond of sin, that she may rejoice in you with your saints forever. Amen. Because God has chosen to call our sister from this, our sister Annie from this life to Himself, He commits her body to the earth. So we are dust, to dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like His in glory. For He is risen, firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace, and raise her up, and raise her body in the last day. Dear friends, in reverence, let us pray to God, the source of all mercies, to raise the dead to life, give our sister eternal life. We pray to the Lord, let your response be, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Annie, and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Annie. Let our faith be our consolation, and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all who are buried in the cemetery. May their suffering be lessened. May their joy be increased. May the lights of glory shine on them. And may they rest in peace. We pray to the Lord, Lord of mercy.
Lord of mercy.
Just longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer the prayer Christ Himself taught us. Our Father, who art
right in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Loving God, from whom all life proceeds, and by His hand the dead are raised again. Though we are sinners, you wish always to hear us. Accept the prayers we offer in sadness for your servant Annie. Deliver her soul from death, number her among your saints, and clothe her with the robe of salvation. To enjoy forever the delights of your kingdom, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help those who mourn for Annie, and accompany all of us in our time of need. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let her perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, for the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Church below the town. settled in this little house. I was proud of all our life. Though we were young and happy then, long, long ago. Or why the tears are in my eyes and I seem so far away. It's just you seem a lot like her when your eyes look into mine. And you smile so much like she did long, long before your time. And you smile so much like she did long, long before your time. Oh, come raise the name. Sorry for my going, and all the sweethearts that e'er I had, they would wish me one more day to stay. What seems it falls unto my lot that I should rise and show. I'll gently rise and softly go. Good night and joy be.